On today's video, I'm showing you how to manually create a retro color grade for your video footage, and that starts right now. Hey guys, Ryan here with Ryan Camp Films. Thank you so much for being here today. Today I'm going to show you guys how to manually use the tools in Adobe Premiere to create a retro or a vintage color grade on your video footage. Now these steps I'm going to be showing you are very quick and very simple, and once you know how to do this yourself, you will be able to quickly change things around and get different looks and vibes depending on what kind of style you're going for. And if you are someone who doesn't like to do things manually and you would rather use LUTs, I am pleased to announce that I have a new retro LUT pack available on the digital store that works great with DSLR footage and has versions that work with Filmic Pro Log version 3 footage as well. So please check that out and you'll be helping support the channel. Alright, so let's get started on this retro color grade. The first thing we're going to do is create a new sequence and import our footage onto the timeline. Now the look that I'm going to be going for in this tutorial is a late 80s, early 90s look. Now this look is going to be kind of faded, kind of blurry. It's going to have more compressed colors, less saturation, and we're going to be adding some film grain on top of that as well. Okay, once your footage is on the timeline, select the clip and then open up your color workspace. Now the first thing I'm going to do is open up the basic tab and I'm going to increase the temperature of my clip just a little bit. Let's also bring down our contrast a little bit. We will head into the creative tab and bring up the vibrance a little bit, and we're going to lower our saturation. And one of the main things we want to do here is take the faded film slider and increase that quite a bit, and give our video footage a washed out look. As you can see, things are really starting to take shape here. It's starting to have that retro look to it. And the next thing we're going to do is go into the levels tab, and we're going to manipulate the red, green, and blue channels a little bit, and we're going to compress the colors in this image a little bit further. Now you can do this tons of different ways depending on what kind of look you're going for. So just take the opposite ends of each level, red, green, and blue, and we're going to just randomly move those around a little bit until we get the look that we like. Okay, I think that's looking pretty good. Now the last step is to add film grain to this image to really bring everything together. Okay, go into your effects tab and search for noise, and then select Noise HLS Auto and drag it over to your video clip. Since we are going for a late 80s, early 90s look, it'll probably look best if we increase the lightness percentage in this effect. If we were going for an older look, we might want to increase the saturation percentage. So let's increase this anywhere between 6 to 10% on the lightness percentage. And that looks pretty good. Now we want to make sure we lower the noise animation speed somewhere between 10 to 15%. And the last thing we want to do is change the grain type from uniform to grain. And if we want to go beyond color grading a little bit and add one more effect to this, we can really take things to the next level and give it that tube TV look that retro video is known for. And that is by adding the mosaic effect to our video clip. So let's head back into our effects bin again and search for mosaic. We will drag the mosaic effect and add it to our video clip. And what this is going to do is take away from some of the sharp edges and make this video clip look a little bit more pixelated. Now there is really no right or wrong way to add this effect. Just play around with it until you get a look that you like. I am going to put the vertical blocks at around 300 and I'm going to set the horizontal blocks to around 1500. I think that looks pretty good for what I'm going for. Now let's render our video here and check this thing out in motion. Awesome. And I think that looks pretty good, guys. Let's recap everything that we went over so you'll have a template that you can follow along with when you're trying to add this effect to your video clip. The first step I took was to increase or decrease the temperature of your video clip depending on what kind of look you're going for. Next, we will bring down our contrast. Then we will bring up our vibrance in the Creative tab and then lower our saturation. Now we will increase the values on our faded film slider. In the Levels tab, manipulate the levels on the red, green, and blue channels to further compress the colors in the image until you get a look that you like. And finally, we can add effects like film grain or the mosaic effect to give our video clip that tube TV look. We can also use overlays here as well if you have them available. And that's pretty much it for this tutorial, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Please let me know what you thought about this video in the comments below. And if you have a different process for retro color grading, please be sure to share it with our community in the comments below as well. Thank you so much for watching the video this long. I really appreciate you. If you did happen to watch the video this long, post the word retro in your comment below so I know who my best viewers are. Be sure to go visit the digital store and check out my new retro LUT pack. Please give this video a like, subscribe, and share it with your friends on social media if you haven't already. I would really appreciate it. Thank you so much for coming along on this filmmaking journey with me. I am Ryan, and I will see you on the next video. Bye-bye.